My mind wasn't looking for it to be an interruption, you know. So, go
ahead. I'm a multimedia student. I've been interested in web design at first, but as I get more into the multimedia part, I took my digital video last spring, mm-hmm. and I got a lot of, out of that. And I also have an interest in photography as well.
Okay.
I'm not sure exactly how I would go into that direction. I don't know, editing or some other people's doing script writing. That's one of how to develop your scripts at first once you get an idea.
Oh, wow. Script writing. Yeah, let me come back to you.
Okay.
Yeah, script writing. I'll cover that a little bit more.
Well, are you sure?
Yeah.
I'm also a multimedia, and Reba and I both worked at the Houston Chronicle.
Oh, awesome.
So, you know, the print industry's a little flat right now. So
yeah, I worked in newspaper and that sort of thing, too.
Yeah.
Well,
I started out, when they call it commercial art, they call it graphic art now.
Yeah.
And then I went to a photography school in Dallas.
Nice.
And so I had worked kind of as a, you know, in the dark room and this and that, but I was in Reba's editing class with Michael Webb. That was really good, I think. And then now I'm taking After Effects.
Oh, good.
And sort of leaning towards, I'm thinking, oh, this film stuff sounds pretty interesting. I don't like to talk about my first marriage, but too much about the guy, but I was married to a science fiction / horror illustrator, so we had a lot of weird production going on. So I've been kind of in this field.
Nice.
A lot, you know, where you just use big old hot lights, and he grabbed whatever freaky friend wanted to, you know, dress up like a mop.
A zombie?
A Spanish moss monster or whatever.
A Spanish moss monster. Okay. Awesome.
It's worth the experience.
Yeah, exactly.
Pictures,
because
I'd love to see.
Oh yeah.
I'll tell you more about him later. Then I was married to a very nice man who recently passed away, so I'm a widow. But losing my job at the Chronicle has, you know, given me more. You know, I'm glad to be back here and learning the ways. Because if you're, and I am doing temp work at Academy in their marketing department.
Oh great. Okay.
For their e-com photos right now.
Oh good.
Tooling.
How long have you been there for, at Academy?
About a year.
About a year.
I'm a permanent tent, but all I'm doing is sitting and cutting out little pictures to put on, you know, it's a job.
Yeah.
Still, I'm in the marketing department. Listen, there's a lot of crazy energy going on.
Oh,
there.
Yeah.
because Academy is a pretty solid company in this economy. So.
Okay. Everyone wants a gun, and everyone wants a pair of boots. So.
They sell a lot of stuff, from dog treats. I can't believe, that's how come I'm still employed there, because they thought they were going to launch it in June, but there's so much testing and so many products, and, you know, maybe in January we'll come out. And then I'll be like, okay, no way.
Right?
I'll be knocking on your door in the
Hey, how's it going? Yeah, well, the Academy thing's over. Do you have any other commercials you're shooting? Well, sure. Let's talk.
Good. Well, I'm a web developer and designer.
Mm-hmm.
I'm more into the coding than anything else. And actually, so I'm just curious. I like to know stuff.
Okay.
I'm a computer geek, I guess.
Good.
I'm involved in anything that has to do with computers.
Mm-hmm. Good.
We're all geeks. What are you talking about? We're here on a Friday night. We're here Fridays and Saturdays.
Yeah. It's good though. You're learning. Count me in.
Yeah.
Count me in the geek club. Go ahead.
Well, I'm in a graphic designer. I work with a company that does. They do like cosmetic stuff, and they're. I guess they're slowly dipping into the whole recording and film and
mm-hmm.
producing that. So. I had somewhat experience on that, so not really experience, but like they just hired a video guy, so
mm-hmm.
he does
good.
All the, so then, well, he came from New York, so I just been working with them. I got into photography as well. And
right.
Bought my the whole digital DSLR camera that shot video.
Sure. Yeah.
So then I. got curious on shooting videos. I shot a couple of videos, posted on YouTube,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
little fun stuff like that. And
a Twilight spoof? No? Okay.
Did my fair share of spoofs.
Okay,
and,
good.
Just random stuff.
Yeah.
Just, and then like slowly I've been doing a lot of research on like film, like filmmakers and
mm-hmm.
stuff like that. They are slowly transitioning to DSLRs and getting the tight angle shots and stuff. So
yeah.
I thought to myself I was kind of ahead of the game
yeah.
In a way because I own one. So.
Yeah, you already have the
yeah.
Yeah.
How
yeah.
much did that cost you?
That's when the T1i came out.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm using. Yeah.
Yeah. I bought that and I spent $1,000 on it
mm-hmm.
with the whole protection and combat.
Yeah.
But I got a couple of lenses as well.
Mm-hmm. Sounds about right.
So, yeah.
You are ahead of me.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, like when I shot Chasing Kane, you know, I had that camera and it, like you said, I spent about $1,400 on it.
Yeah, I was actually disappointed after they released the T2. I was
yeah.
like,
yeah. Yeah. I was just playing with it the other day, the T2, and I was like, just one button away from being able
right.
to manually control my iris and manually control my shutter. So.
I'm just like curious because I heard a while back that a lot of directors was like resistant against the digital. They still like the 35mm film and wanted to keep that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, does that still hold true?
Yeah,
or?
But at some point it's going to go like. Well, let me clarify. You can shoot on film. That's not a problem.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you're Michael Caine, oh, I'm sorry, if you're, you know, Michael Bay,
mm-hmm.
and you're shooting Transformers, you can shoot on whatever you want, you know, because Paramount is paying the bills, right? And Jerry Bruckheimer, no, and Steven Spielberg is taking care of it. So you shoot whatever you want. But for, you know, independent filmmakers, a lot of them are switching to that because of the budget. It's a lot cheaper. It's a lot more cost-effective to shoot on that type of camera and still get the look of something that looks professional. So understand, yes, when you make your big money and you want to shoot your feature on, you know, 35.
Don't you have to convert it to digital? Edit it.
Smart
there.
Man. I was just about to go there.
That sounds like extra work.
I was just about to go there. I was like, yes, you do have to take that and digitize it. You know,
it's double work.
Yeah, so... You know, once you get that film, you take it to the lab, get it exposed, everything like that, and then you transfer it down to something that you can edit on. Be it, you know, if you want to do it 4K, you can. If you wanted to do something smaller, like an HD platform, HD cam platform, yeah, you can. So.
And also more
on the film for distribution.
Yeah. Yeah. Or you just distribute it, you know, on a low-cost scale on HD, because everything now is doing that, you know, you go to the digital version at the theater now, you know, so it never sees film.
But
yeah.
They had to change stuff they had to change makeup on HD too, because regular filmmaking on regular film, you can use just about any makeup because you have lens, you have a reflection because they have titanium dioxide in the makeup, and in HD it picks up. So they had to go with non-reflective makeup.
Yes.
For staging.
Yes.
Oh, I used to be in the makeup industry for a long time.
Yeah.
That was my
The makeup girls on the production I was just on, and she kept going, are we shooting on HD, or what kind of camera is that? She kept walking over to the camera
and
looking at it.
I used to work for, also for Smashbox, which they do a lot of the film makeup.
Yeah.
Because they have the HD foundation.
Right.
And there's a certificate you can get, because they have a studio in, I believe it's L.A.,
Yeah.
And they have they show you how to put on the makeup for HD because
right.
it looks much different.
Yeah. Isn't it less or something, or what is it? It's less because you can't put as much on,
well,
or you don't do a foundation or something?
Well, you have to
concealer?
Put, you have to put three layers.
No, I'm getting
in
really
reality,
into this.
There's a three-layer rule because the HD will automatically eat three layers off your makeup.
Yeah.
So they use HD foundation is actually really light.
Yeah.
So if you put one, it's like you're wearing nothing. If you wear three or four coats, you can see that they're not really wearing makeup. It just looks kind of like a natural clean skin tone.
Right.
But you have to have more than three. But there's the way they put on the blush and everything. It has to be at, you know, A certain way put on, but a certain heaviness, for it to show on TV.
Right.
It has to be the thickness or whatever you want to call it, the contrast, certain contrast, I should say, the word contrast has to be done correctly. Otherwise, your model on TV doesn't look like she's wearing anything.
Yeah.
You can't really see it.
Hmm. Well, that's interesting, Pablo. I remember pancake makeup when
No, not pancake. Not on HD though. Non-reflective titanium.
Pancake makeup. Nice. Sorry, I didn't mean to get it, but I was like, oh, it sounds good. I've heard that, but I never figured, you know, how.
Yeah, well, Smashbox is really good. That's what they do. Smashbox Foundation is designed for the Devin HD Foundation, which was designed for Hollywood for HD filmmaking.
For HD filming specifically.
It's called Smashbox.
Smashbox.
That stuff's expensive.
It sure is.
Yeah, that's awesome, though.
I work in a cosmetic company, but so it's not like I do research or anything.
Yeah.
But like they have like HD makeup and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And I said like what he said, and it's crazy how like certain.
Yeah, because you know HD, you can see your pores and it's all this detail. So the next thing you know, if you put.